Now there may be some questions on conjugate hyperbola as well. Now suppose we have a hyperbola whose equation is x square upon a square minus y square upon b square, and this is equal to 1. Then if we'll replace this 1 with minus 1, then we'll get another hyperbola whose equation is x square upon a square minus y square upon b square equals minus 1, which we can also write as y square upon b square minus x square upon a square equals to 1. And these hyperbolas, they are called as conjugate hyperbolas of each other. So for this hyperbola x square upon a square minus y square upon b square equals to 1, equation of conjugate hyperbola is y square upon b square minus x square upon a square equals 1. Now for this hyperbola, transverse axis is plus minus a comma 0 and conjugate axis is 0 comma plus minus b, and for this transverse axis is 0 comma plus minus b and conjugate axis is plus minus a comma 0. So transverse axis for one is conjugate for another and vice versa, and that is the reason they are called conjugate hyperbolas. Now the one result which is important in case of conjugate hyperbola is relationship between their eccentricities. Say for example, eccentricity for this first hyperbola is say E1, and for this conjugate hyperbola say the eccentricity is E2. Now using relationship between A and B, we can write B square, it is A square into E1 square minus 1. So from here we can write E1 square as B square plus A square upon A square, and we can also write 1 upon E1 square as A square upon A square plus B square. Here A and B, they are interchanged. So this is A and this is actually B. So we can write A square equals B square and E2 square minus 1. So from here we can write E2 square is A square plus B square upon B square, then 1 upon E2 square is B square upon A square plus B square. Now if we'll add them, then we can write 1 upon E1 square plus 1 upon E2 square, and this is A square plus B square upon A square plus B square, which is simply 1. So relationship between eccentricities of conjugate hyperbola is 1 upon E1 square plus 1 upon E2 square, it is equal to 1. For a given hyperbola, if we have to write equation of conjugate hyperbola, so we'll just need to replace this 1 with minus 1. And the relationship between their eccentricities is 1 upon E1 square plus 1 upon E2 square is always equal to 1. Now we'll draw these conjugate hyperbolas, then we'll draw the axis. We'll draw asymptotes. This is y equals b upon ax, and this is y equals minus b upon ax, and then we'll mark all these 4 points. So this is a comma 0 and minus a comma 0, and this one is 0 comma b and 0 comma minus b. Now we'll draw this first hyperbola. So that's our first hyperbola, which is x square upon a square minus y square upon b square equals to 1. And then the second hyperbola, it'll be the one which is drawn in green. So these two hyperbolas, they are called as conjugate hyperbolas of each other. Now there'll be questions on rectangular hyperbolas as well. So if in hyperbola, if a is equal to b, then we call that hyperbola a rectangular hyperbola. So its equation will be x square minus y square is equal to a square if it is of the first form, or it will be y square minus x square, and this is equal to a square. Now for rectangular hyperbola, if we'll find its eccentricity, then we know that both a and b, they are same. So we can simply write a square is equal to a square into e square minus 1. Now here a square will cancel. We'll get e square equals 2. That is, the value of e is root 2. So eccentricity of a rectangular hyperbola is always root 2. It doesn't matter which form it is. It will always be root 2. So eccentricity for rectangular hyperbola is root 2. And if we'll write, it's asymptotes. Now we know that asymptotes are y equals plus minus b upon ax. Now b and a, they are same. So asymptotes will be simply y equals plus or minus x. So one of the line is y equals to x and another line is y equals to minus x. And these two asymptotes, they are perpendicular. And that is the reason we call this hyperbola a rectangular hyperbola. Now we'll draw this hyperbola. So first we'll draw the axis. And then we'll draw the asymptotes. So this is y equals x and this is y equals minus x. Now this is a comma 0 and minus a comma 0. So this one is minus a comma 0 and this is a comma 0. So we can draw this hyperbola. One branch on the left and the other one on the right. And this second hyperbola, it is nothing but it is conjugate hyperbola for this first hyperbola. So we can mark these points 0 comma a and 0 comma minus a, and then we can draw this second hyperbola on the same setup. So for rectangular hyperbola, angle between asymptotes is always 90 degrees and its eccentricity will always be root 2. Now the next question is, if P is a point on rectangular hyperbola, x square minus y square equals to a, C is its center and S, S dash are two foci, then S P into S dash P is. So here we have a rectangular hyperbola. This is y equals x and this is y equals minus x, and then we have two branches of hyperbola. Now for rectangular hyperbola, we know that value of E is simply root 2. So it has two focus, S and S dash. So suppose this is S and this is S dash. So it'll be minus root 2a comma 0 and this one is root 2a comma 0 and center is at origin. Now it says P is any one point on this rectangular hyperbola. So we have S, P and S dash P. So this S, P, it will be A E secant theta plus 1 and S, P dash will be A E secant theta minus 1. So we'll multiply them, we'll get S, P into S dash P and will be a square into e square secant square theta minus 1. Now we'll find cp square. Now this p is a secant theta and b tan theta. So this cp square, it will be a square secant square theta plus b square tan square theta. Now what we'll do is we'll write b square as a square into e square minus 1. So we'll write this as a square, we'll take common. So it'll be secant square theta and plus e square minus 1 tan square theta. So we can write this as a square and it'll be e square tan square theta. And then secant square theta minus tan square theta is plus 1. And the question, it says it is a rectangular hyperbola. So we know that value of E is simply root 2. So we'll put E as root 2. Then we can write S P into S dash P as a square into 2 secant square theta minus 1, and here we can write it as a square into 2 tan square theta plus 1, and we know that tan square theta is secant square theta minus 1. So it'll again be a square to secant square theta minus 1. So from here we can say sp into s dash p is equal to cp square, and that's your option number B. Now here the question is, if hyperbola has one focus at origin and its eccentricity is root 2, and one of the directrices x plus y plus 1 equals to 0, then we need to find center of the hyperbola. So we have this hyperbola whose focus is at origin and whose directrix is x plus y plus 1 equals to 0. So this is the directrix x plus y plus 1 equals to 0. Now we need to find center of this hyperbola. Now first what we'll do is we'll find transverse axis of this hyperbola, and transverse axis of this hyperbola will be perpendicular to directrix and will pass through focus. So basically transverse axis for this hyperbola is x minus y equals to 0, and since center will lie on this line, so this center will be of the form say h comma h. Now distance of center from focus, it will be root 2h, and distance of center from directrix will simply be 2h plus 1 upon root 2. Now we know that distance between center and focus is a into e, so ae is equal to root 2h, and a upon e is simply 2h plus 1 upon root 2. Now we need to eliminate a. So what we'll do is we'll divide these two equations. So we'll divide them, a and a will cancel. So we'll get e square, and e square will be 2h upon 2h plus 1. Now eccentricity is simply root 2. So e square will be 2. So we'll get 2h plus 1 equals to h. So value of h is minus 1. So therefore center of this hyperbola will be at minus 1 comma minus 1. So this is how we can find center to this hyperbola. Another way of solving this question can be, since we have directrix, eccentricity and focus, we know that PS equals EPM. Now what's PS? PS simply will be under root of x square plus y square, and will be root 2, and PM will be x plus y plus 1 upon root 2. Now we can square it, and then we can get general equation of hyperbola, and we know that we can find center of any conic by simply differentiating the equation with respect to x partially and differentiating it with respect to y, and then solving these two linear equations to get center of this hyperbola, which again will be minus 1 comma minus 1.